hands together for the South Shields team, ladies and gentlemen. Fantastic achievement. Congratulations from everybody here at Guisborough Town Football Club on your achievements, and also for reaching three finals, obviously. So they'll be in their last league game, but three finals after that. A very, very big congratulations indeed. Today marks the end of an era as club legend David Onions hangs up his boots and retires for the final time after today's match.
Do what we thought on today's 3-2 loss against South Shields?
I thought we were a little bit unlucky, to be honest. Pretty similar to the Mass game last week. I think if we'd have got a goal, it's a 2-1. I think we might have gone and even pinched the win. But goals change games, so a little bit unlucky in the end, really.
And do?
Yeah, same as Lee. Like you say, last week against Mask, I thought Monday we started off bright. First 20 minutes we could have nicked one, it could have been a different game. Today, we started off a little bit sluggish, they got the goal, put us on the back foot. We got back into the game and then we've had chances, but it just wasn't to be. It's one of them days. They're a good side, they've won the league. But lads can be proud of themselves, they've done everything they could. put everything in today, and we've come a long way since Gaz took over, so can't ask for much more, really.
Very emotional day for yourself too. How do you feel after?
Yeah, like I say, before the game, it was nice to get the accolade there and do what I did. But when the game started, it was all about the game. It was forgotten about. It's about Guisborough Town, and we tried to stay up, tried to do what we can do. We won 5 games on the bounce. Any other time, that would have been enough to stay up, but unfortunately, we fell a little bit short. So it's a bit sweet, to be honest.
Now, you've also been involved with Guisborough for a long time. What do you think of your teammate, David Onions?
I've said it a lot of times. He's probably my best mate in football, to be honest. We've played for a number of clubs together.
Yeah, so
I've probably played more games with Dave than anybody else. So he's been a great player over the years, and to be fair, I still think he's got a lot to offer. But he will be missed next year. I understand that. Obviously, family and work issues got to take precedence. So if he's time to call it a day, then so be it.
I think even a few teary eyes from supporters and
I say, emotional, especially walking on my daughters at the beginning there. That's obviously gonna be a bit of a tearjerker, and they've been down, and even when the girls were born, I was getting stick off the missus last night, because when my daughter's born, I went and played football in the afternoon. She was born at 6 in the morning, and I played them that day, so they've been there from the start. So yeah, it was a bit of an emotional one, but like Lee said, I've grew up with a lot of these lads, and it's been a massive part of my life, and I'll miss it. And like Lee said, I'll still stay in touch, because you get friends for life in this Northern League game, and that's what I've got. So it's been, I'm privileged to have done this, what I've done.
Who do you think stood out for you as a man of the match?
This man here. Since we've come back, like I said, we've said it since we've come back. Lee came back in after Steve left, and Gaz brought him in. And to be honest, he's been absolute rock for us. He's been consistent. He's been, for me, player of the season by a country mile. He's been consistent every single game. Young lads have been on fire at times. Stevie Roberts at goal sacks. They've done absolutely tremendous. For me, Lee's been consistent week in, week out, and again today, I don't think he lost a header again. Absolutely superb. And the full-backs, like I say, we've talked about the full-backs, well, they've been superb. So yeah, it's, but you can't look further than Mr. By the way there.
I think it seems that every interview we do, they seem to mention your calm and collectiveness, Lee, to be honest.
It's about time. It's only took me a 33-year-old to get those type of things. So.
Who would you say was a man of match for you, Lee?
It's quite difficult, I think. I think a lot of the lads have had a good game today. I mean, obviously, I would say they're probably the best assembled squad that I've seen at this level since I've started playing. So I think for us to think that we're in the game, everybody must have played well. Thought Gary was excellent first half. Obviously, it's difficult. He's been out the side for the last 6 games. And to come in and have the 45 that he did, I thought he did really well for the first 45. But I can't really fault any of the lads' performance today. The work rate and the commitment was spot on, definitely.
Obviously, you're hanging up your boots, but how do you think that Guisborough's chances in the future will be? Should we go down to Division 2?
I've said it before, and I've said to the gaffer there, I said, no matter what division we're in, the future's massive for Guisborough. The future's so bright. I've been in change rooms for the last 18, 19 seasons, and I don't think I've seen so much potential now in that Guisborough change room. 1 point in one game, I came off, sat on the bench last 10 minutes, and the guy said there was 10, apart from the goalkeeper, or maybe the goalkeeper, under 21 players on that field. So in terms of turning over the talent and bringing them through, it's absolutely massive in there, and I'll be down to support them, and I look forward to seeing the Goldsacks and the Roberts maybe on Match of the Day in 6 or 7 years, and that's how good they are. They've got so much potential to move on, and with experienced players like Gary Wood and Lee and Pooley alongside them, they can only get better. Gaz has done a fantastic job since he's come in and bring these guys on, and they're only going to develop, and it'll be good to see in the future's come. Future's definitely bright.
Some of the thoughts, Lee?
Yeah, it is like an unbelievably young squad, really. You look around at times, and I think maybe for the last 6 games, it's only been myself, Pooley and Dave who were over 20, 21, I think that's right.
Yeah,
and I think to play First Division Northern League level, it's difficult. And to be fair, I think it took the lads a little bit of time to adjust to it. The likes of Snooky and Matty and Dylan, but then you've seen the back half of the season that they've learned how to play at this level, they've learned how to adapt to it, and then they've come on. So I dare say next season they'll probably go from strength to strength.
Thank you, guys.
Excellent. Cheers, mate.
Cheers, mate. Cheers.
Come on, dude.
Cheers, mate.
Gary, what were your thoughts on today's 3-2 loss against South Shields?
Ultimately, obviously, very, very disappointed. Because we finished in the bottom three now. So, although points on the pitch won, we didn't finish in the bottom three. We were a couple of points ahead, I think, of Washington. Obviously I wasn't there when that happened, and I think it was a little bit unlucky and a bit unfortunate that we have lost the 3 points. It doesn't seem right to me, obviously being a football person, and like you say, I've talked to lads there who are football people, and the reasons behind it don't seem right to me, and I think the league maybe need to look at that. Obviously if people are playing ineligible players and things, they're not, it's right, they should be punished hard, but I don't think someone who's played for 3 years and signs a form to start a season should be classed as ineligible, but I'll save that one for another day. Today I thought we'd give everything. We obviously up against it. The biggest, we've left ourselves with the biggest challenge. Party time for them. But I think second half we deserved a couple of goals there. We've been, again, we had a few chances against Mask, but the deal even more so. I think we've hit the bar, had one clear off the line. I think Gary Wood's been put in and he could have scored. So ultimately very disappointed, because I think we could have upset everybody there and pinched the result.
Who would you say stood out for you in the match?
I'll have to give Gary Wood some credit, because he sat on the bench patiently. He's come in there, first 5 minutes I thought, oh, he looks off it, but then off the pace of the game. After that, he's done everything I've asked of him, so he's a great character to have in there, as Onions has been, and as Lee has been, and Pooley, the older lads, have really helped the young lads towards the back end of the season. But Gary Wood was excellent, and I thought Snook had a great second half, so we were tossed up between one of them, really.
I think certainly with Snook and McAvoy over the last months have just shown what potential we've got, as well as the...
Yeah, there could be the best two fullbacks in the league in 3 or 4 years if they keep going the way. I mean, I've just said that there a few weeks ago, nobody would have dared say that. But the side's full of promise, and they're two of the lads who are full of promise.
We will have to wait to see what the Northern League decides in terms of how many teams they will relegate, whether or not we'll just miss out on the spot or not. But how does planning for next season look? I know we've only just finished the season, but...
I think a lot will depend on what division we do end up in. Obviously, it looks like we're going to be relegated. Whether that remains to be seen, obviously, that's for again, a decision not for me. Like I said, on the pitch, we did enough to stop up. It looks like off the pitch there's going to be reasons why we don't stop up, or whether we do stop up, that's got to be decided by other people. Either way, I think the majority of the squad will be here. The majority of the squad are young. If I can bring the right people in, regardless of what division we're in, the future looks good.
Thank you, Gary.
Right, cheers, thanks.
Cheers.